Do you know what? I've been recording for 48 minutes now. You were right about some of these.
It's things. Also the longest chapter.
Yeah. I mean, I thought you were actually exaggerating about some of the chapters taking about an hour, but seriously?
I was not.
I may have to split this up into more than two parts. If it goes on any longer. Anyway, back in the new present, the delicious aroma of chicken fills the air, but I'm still thinking about Lynne. I wonder if she's still waiting for her chicken to be served. I decided to go see her. See her and ask her the questions that were still consuming me. Right. There we go. Dial. The chicken kitchen. The disastrous accident has been completely erased. Once again, I saved the red-headed detective from death. Saved Lynne, the quote-unquote criminal who stole my life.
She's a hardened criminal.
One question in particular hangs heavy on my mind. Why did she shoot me? Until I know the answer, I'll never be satisfied.
Maybe she sneezed.
Meanwhile, Lynne's appetite is apparently foremost in her mind. A golden brown chicken sits on the table in front of her. Until she eats the whole thing, she'll probably never be satisfied. So, what we need to do is... Now, I can't get any further at this point, so... Remember the trick? Is Lynne having a serious talk with that detective? Nah, she's just gobbling down chicken. How did the detective know to stake out this restaurant tonight? I better see if I can get some information, but more importantly, I have lots of questions for that lady detective. So remember this. 1, 2, 3. There you go. Oh, I didn't know you were here, Detective Ringed. Come to see me, did you? Oh, that's so sweet. Oh, hi, Memory. Don't mind us. Just pretend we're not here. Why don't you try some chicken while you're here? No thanks. Just watching Lynne eat's quite enough for me. So how did it turn out with my ladybug? Oh, that listening device? Well, let's see. I thought the gentleman had a very nice singing voice. Sorry, but we're in the middle of an important talk. Could you leave us to it? No, stay right there. Huh? I'm at the crucial moment with this chicken here. I'll need you to pour me some water if it starts going down wrong. Lynne, you don't have to risk your life over chicken, you know. He's right, sheesh. Anyway, I better move now while I have the chance. That's funny. Even though I just saved the detective, he doesn't have a call. Not like the one Lynne has, or that valiant little doggy missile. I thought the ones I save are supposed to develop cores when they're alive again. I guess I still have things to learn about these powers of the dead. Well, I'm heading back. Lots of things to do, you know. Yeah, like washing dishes and planting bugs. Someday I'll plant a big one on you, detective. Odd girl. I agree. Me too. See, even though the deaths have been erased, that odd girl thing just happens to stay there.
Mm-hmm.
It's also like certain things, like the position of Sissel's body. I mean, in the first instance, the Jigo kicked it down the stairs, and once he changed Lynne's fate, the cat knocked it down and it ended up in the same position. And certain subtle things like that. But anyway, 53 minutes, let's continue. You've explained your side and I understand, but there's an APB out of you. On you. Ugh. Whatever. Can't you at least hurry up and get out of here? You know, slip away quietly? No can do, I'm meeting someone here. Meeting someone? Oh yeah, that's right. The little lady, Camilla. But why do you have to meet someone here? The Special Investigation Unit is watching this restaurant tonight. How can that be a coincidence? I don't know, but it is coincidence. Hey, is it true what they say? That you're still looking into Detective Jowd's case on your own? Inspector Cabanella is worried about you, no? I understand how you feel, but just don't do anything crazy, okay? Talk. So how's that chicken you've been waiting so long for? It's great. But you know, with Detective Ringed, that's his name by the way, sitting right across from me. I mean, he was just dead a few moments ago, right? That's kind of taking the edge off my appetite. Oh, brother. But he's a great guy. He understands my situation, he said. He's going to give me a pass just for tonight. Speaking of Detective Ringed, I noticed something strange. He doesn't have a call now. He doesn't? I thought a call was supposed to show up once I saved somebody. I wonder if... When you possessed his corpse, he was unconscious, right? Unconscious? Yeah, he was, wasn't he? Just like you, you were unconscious the first time I saved you. And after I saved you, you didn't have a core either. So for people who are unconscious when you save them, no core shows up. I think that's probably what it is.
Sorry about this for a moment. I'm going to mute my microphone.
Okay. You might be right. Okay, I'll leave Ringe to you then. But I've still got lots of questions for you. Yeah, I thought you would. Let's get started then. Death Row Inmate Jowd. What is your connection to Prisoner D99 Detective Jowd? He seems like more than just a co-worker. Yes, I suppose you have the right to know. Detective Jowd is my hero. Hero, huh? You don't hear that much. You don't hear that word much anymore. Jeez, what's wrong with you tonight? Well, it's an old-fashioned heroic kind of story. It happened 10 years ago. Now calm down. Just calm down and drop that weapon. Stay back. If you come any closer, I'll shoot her. On that day 10 years ago, I was playing in my favourite park. And then suddenly somebody grabbed my arm from behind. I was so scared I thought I was going to die. And then... he appeared, Detective Jowd. And then that really loud sound, I think it was the sound of a gun. I passed out. When I came to... You're alright now, are you hurt? You saved me, mister? I was just doing my job. The guards, they're the ones who saved you. What's your job, mister? Me? I'm a police detective. So that's why you became a detective, huh? That's right. He was my ideal of what a detective was all about. But an ideal detective doesn't shoot and kill his own wife. Exactly. And that's why I want to prove that he didn't. And by that clicking, I'm assuming you're back.
Maybe.
No, that just proves it. Okay, point X. Detective Ringe works for the Special Investigation Unit. He said that an important deal is set to go down here tonight at this restaurant. A deal that could affect the future of our nation. A nation isn't something that's easily influenced, though. But that's what he said. Anyway, it's that couple at the table upstairs. I hear they're foreigners. They're waiting for the other party in this deal to show up now. Those two, huh? They certainly are an odd pair. Is this other party they're waiting for me? It's kind of hard to imagine, isn't it? Nobody really knows any of the details of the deal except for one person. Inspector Cabanella.
Mr. Dancy Pants.
Mr. Breezy Dancer in a white suit. They say he's been watching the movements of those two for a long time. I've never seen him work so frantically on an investigation before. Inspector Cavanella, huh? Apparently you're a real favourite of his. A favourite? Yes, well, there's a reason for that. And what's that? Inspector Cavanella and Detective Jowd were good friends. Yeah, I think I remember the prison guard saying something about that. They joined the detective division the very same day. They're two very different types, but they're always in friendly competition to be the best. Detective Jowd was always particular about thorough investigation of the crime scene. And Inspector Cavanella, well, I guess he just has a natural genius for investigating. Anyway, those two led the division, detective division in those days. But Inspector Cavanella is different now. He's changed a little. He changed? Ever since the Detective Jowd incident, now he distances himself from field work. And he's starting to focus on nothing but moving up the ladder. And so that's how he became head of the Special Investigation Unit, I take it. Anyway, Inspector Cavanella took me under his wing. Because you were the little girl his good friend had saved, huh? He really looked out for me, helping me study for my detective's exam. Fudging my exam scores for me. that goes a little beyond the scope of looking out for you. Inspector Cavanella, I wonder what role he plays in everything that's happening tonight. And we've just hit an hour recording.
Nice.
Yeah. Wow, this is long. I'm going to have to split this up into several parts, I think, unfortunately.
Probably about four or five.
I didn't want to. Oh, dear. Anyway, Camilla. It sure is taking Camilla long enough. She should have been here by now. I'm getting really worried. You two are... Darren! You two are like sisters, aren't you? That's what Camilla said. Yep, that just about sums it up. It doesn't look like being worried affects your appetite much, though. Hey, the bigger the crisis, the more a girl's gotta eat. I have to make sure Camilla is always stays safe no matter what. Camilla and that music box, too. Music box? Oh yeah, that wooden box. The one that Sissel helped her find. That box was a present from Detective Jowd. From Detective Jowd? Yes, it was 5 years ago. That box arrived 3 days after that murder incident. He must have sent it just before he was arrested. Someday when the case is over and everything is settled, I want you to give this to a certain person, he said. So what's inside? I don't know, I can't open it. That's a shame. Sissel, did I really shoot you? Where did that come out of the blue? I really don't remember. I've tried and tried, but I just can't. Now I finally understand how you must feel, and how hard it is to have your memory gone, your story erased. But who knows, knowing the truth might be even harder. I'd rather believe there's hope myself. That was great. She finally finished the chicken. Do I have chicken on my face? You're staring. I bet you're thinking about how impressed you are with the way I took care of that chicken. Just tell me one thing. This case you say you're looking into, is it Detective Jowd's? What if it was? I can't keep it from you. It's too cruel. Huh? What are you talking about? I'm sorry, Lynne. It's tonight. Detective Jowd's, you know, it's tonight. His execution. But there's still time. I looked into it and I found out that all executions in this country are carried out at dawn. That may be the norm, but that's not this time, I'm afraid. What? The execution is set for 11 p.m. What did you say? It's going to happen pretty soon. Isn't there anything we can do to stop it? Of course not. It's too late now. Not without a stay of execution from the Justice Minister. I'm going to see him then. What? See who? Who else but Justice Minister? Don't be ridiculous, there's not enough time. I'm going, Sissel! Me? Get to the prison, stop that execution! Easy enough for you to say. Detective Ringe, I'll be going now. Okay, I'll let you go this time. I'll tell him I was distracted because I was eating chicken. Is there anything else I can do? Could you find Camilla? She's supposed to be on her way here. Oh, your little Camilla? Okay, you've got it. I'll look for her. Okay, you know what to do, Sissel. You have to save Detective Jowd. Again, easy enough for you to say. The life of yet another person I'm connected to somehow is about to end tonight. Could it be a coincidence? Or is there something more behind it all? Detective Jowd is destined to be executed tonight. I don't know if that fate is the wrong one for him or the right one, but I've decided to go to the prison anyway. And finally! Save your current place and time. Yes. Right! At 64 minutes, we have finally come to the end of Chapter 7. Unfortunately...
Wow.
Yeah. So, yes, you were right. Unfortunately, looks like some of these later chapters are going to be a lot.
Some? Every chapter gets longer from now on.
No, some of them... No, not really. Some aren't. At least that's been my experience so far. I mean, chapter 1 and 2 were pretty long, and chapter 3 was really short. It's because we didn't have anyone to save in chapter 3. But I think chapter 8 is probably going to be one of the longest, just because of having to rescue Detective Jowd.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
That's the next one?
Yes, that'll be the next one. So, next time, we will be heading to the prison to go rescue Detective Jowd and stop him from being executed. So, until next time, farewell, my friends, and I will see you soon.
Bye.